Good evening. Have you noticed that films are never simply re-released anymore? They have to be dusted down, tarted up, refurbished and repolished. Characters and special effects are added, the sound is tweaked and digitalised, and hey, presto, we're presented with a definitive version, a director's cut, or in the case of Star Wars, a special edition. But what, you may ask, is so special about the special Star Wars, apart from the technical changes, which I do not propose to go into here because I've left my anorak at home? Well, Jabba the Hutt, not previously seen until the second sequel, The Return of the Jedi, now has a brief scene with Harrison Ford, or Han Solo, as we like to think of him. And Luke Skywalker, a.k.a. Mark Hamill, is reunited with an old mate before they both go off to tackle the Death Star.
It's like an Imperial cruiser. Our passengers must be hotter than I thought. Try and hold them off. Angle the deflector shield while I make the calculations for the jump to light speed. Stay sharp. There's two more coming in. They're going to try and cut us off.
Why didn't y'all run them? I thought you said this thing was fast.
Watch your mouth, kid. You're going to find yourself floating home.
We'll be safe enough once we make the jump to hyperspace. Besides, I know a few maneuvers. We'll lose them. Here's where the fun begins.
How long before you can make the jump to light speed?
Take a few moments to get the coordinates from the navicomputer.
Are you kidding? The rate they're gaining?
Traveling through hyperspacing like dust and crops, boy. Without precise calculations, we'd fly right through a star or bounce too close to a supernova and then end your trip real quick, wouldn't it?
What's that flashing?
Losing a deflector shield.
Don't trap yourselves in. I'm gonna make the jump to light speed.
The additions are all fairly negligible, but interesting enough, and I suppose they do add something to what was always a smashing movie anyway, a devilishly clever blend of practically every cinema genre you can mention, from romantic comedy to the western, the medieval epic, science fiction, and, of course, the age-old struggle of good versus evil. Always a belter was that, as Eric Morecambe used to say. You could argue that this special edition is simply a ruse to squeeze yet more revenue out of one of the most lucrative films ever made. But beyond that, it also reminds us that a film can be a living thing, constantly subject to alteration and improvement. What the special edition really underlines, though, is that if you haven't seen Star Wars on the big screen, and most people haven't, then you've never really seen it at all, and you should. However, I imagine there are those among you who are keen to know precisely what writer-director George Lucas has done to his 20-year-old movie. So I asked him, and happily Lucas did have his anorak with him, and so was able to oblige.
That boy is our last hope.
No. There is another.
Star Wars was designed to be a theatrical experience. It was designed to be on the big screen. Sound is extremely important, and it's very important to the overall enjoyment of the film that it be big.
They're coming in too fast!
There were various things, especially in the original film, that I wasn't satisfied with. Special effect shots that never really were finished, scenes that I wanted to include that couldn't have been included for some reason, mostly money and time.
The essence of the storytelling had to be sacrificed for the limits of technology. George had very specific shots that he wanted to be able to achieve, but it was extremely difficult to do that with models on wires. So although for us in 1977, when we first saw it, it was still powerful, it was still big. He never got visually the dynamic shots that he actually wanted to get. So we've redone those.
See? One of the things we were concerned with right from the beginning was we certainly didn't want it to suddenly look like a brand new, different looking shot every time we dropped in one of the redos or improved or new shot. So we began early on to make sure that it was possible for us to take a shot, scan it digitally, work on it, do the things to what we want to do, film it back out, and then cut it back in and have it not seem like a different animal.
This is all your fault.
We didn't want to throw out the sound in the film and do it over. There were so many plastic things in it. So many things that we couldn't do better. And they also represent what the film is and how it's known to people. So that we did our best to bring them to the audience as clearly and as high fidelity as possible now. redesigned the sound field in the film to bring more of the sound off to go around the audience, so a spaceship can fly from behind you and move all the way to another corner, this sort of thing.
There goes another one.
Hold your fire. There's no life forms.
The actual motion of Jabba never really existed before. This is something we had discussed with George Lucas, and he said, well, basically, I want him to move, right? So that's a problem now, because we don't really know how we move. So we had the concept of a slug initially, and then he had the concept of saying that, well, maybe he has a whole bunch of little legs off the side, and they sort of come out like an anemone, right, and actually help him scurry. So initially, we sort of went for that approach. Over time, it became evident that the mass of the character would allow us to make him move like a sea lion, right? So that's essentially what I did. I made him move like a sea lion. This project here was about 5 shots, took about a year to do.
The ultimate goal is to make it look like Jabba was on the set talking to Harrison Ford, and we just photographed it. This is the original plate that George shot. So the plan was for us to remove this actor and replace him with Jabba. He had to be physically in that space where this actor was, doing all the same things in a similar kind of style.
For me, I got to remake the movie and get it to be finished the way I want, so I'm perfectly happy. But it would be fun to be able to share that intangible part of the experience of seeing it in a large theater with hopefully millions of people.
I'm not afraid.
You will be.
Well, as a footnote to all that, special editions of The Empire Strikes Back and The Return of the Jedi will open next month. And so